So let us take a quick recap of what Ohm's law stated. Ohm's law stated that voltage across a given conductor is directly proportional to the current flowing along the conductor, provided that temperature and all other physical conditions remain constant. So as you can see, if we increase the voltage, then the current flowing will also increase. Likewise, if we decrease the voltage, then the current flowing through the conductor will also decrease. Now over here we have a relation of proportionality. In order to convert it into a relation of equality, we have introduced a proportionality constant R. This proportionality constant is known as resistance, and the numerical statement of Ohm's law is V is equals IR. Over here V, which is the voltage or the potential difference, is represented or measured in volts. I, which is the current, is measured in ampere. So from this relation we get that R is equal to V by I, and R is given in terms of ohms. So Ohm's law states that as V increases, I increases, and this R remains constant for constant temperature and all other physical conditions remaining constant. So let us see how we can verify Ohm's law. First, we consider a simple arrangement of a circuit. In this circuit, a battery has been considered along with a resistance across which Ohm's law will have to be verified. Here we have also considered a variable resistance in order to regulate the flow of current in the circuit. That is, the current which will be flowing in the circuit will be regulated by the value of the variable resistance. Using this variable resistance, we can increase or decrease the value of this resistance, which will in turn lead to an increase or decrease of the value of current flowing through the subject resistance or the resistance across which we have to verify Ohm's law. So the value of this resistance is not known to us previously. So let us find out what happens if we take different readings of voltage and current. So here we have considered the readings of voltage and current with the help of voltmeter and ammeter. The voltmeter reading is across the resistance which we are considering, and the current reading is for the entire circuit, which is also the current through the resistance. So we have considered three readings. In these three readings, as we changed the value of the rheostat, we found that the ammeter reading changed. That is, we decreased the resistance of the rheostat and the value of current increased. Along with the increase in the value of current, we found that there was a simultaneous increase in the voltage across the resistor being considered. That is, for 0.5 volts, we have 0.2 amperes. For 1.125 volts, we have 0.45 amperes. And for 1.35 volts, we have 0.54 amperes. Now, if we take the ratio of V and I, that is, if we perform V by I, we will see that this ratio is constant for all the three sets of readings, that is equal to 2.5. So we have seen that V by I is nothing but the resistance of a conductor. So if we divide the voltage across the conductor by the current flowing across the conductor, we come up with a value that is constant, or the resistance of the given conductor. Thus, this verifies Ohm's law. So what do you think will happen if we are to plot these values on a graph, keeping V or volt on the y-axis and I or current on the x-axis? Since V by I is a constant, we get a straight line curve. That is, we get a line that passes through the origin. Now, if you consider the equation of a straight line, it was y equals mx plus c. So in this case, c is the intercept on the y-axis. But in this case, this line is passing through the origin, so there is no intercept on the y-axis. So the intercept is zero. So this equation, v equals ri, gives us a straight line because it is similar to y equals mx. That is the equation of a straight line through the origin. If you observe closely, v has been plotted on the y-axis, I has been plotted on the x-axis, and m is the slope of a straight line in a straight line equation, and this is nothing but r. So in other words, r is the slope of the straight line that we get when we plot the values of voltage along with current. So materials are classified on whether or not they follow Ohm's law. Materials which follow Ohm's law are known as ohmic materials, and materials which do not follow Ohm's law are known as non-ohmic materials. As you can see, in this picture, a copper wire has been shown. This is an example of an ohmic material. An ohmic material is a material which has a linear relationship in between voltage and current. That is a line passing through the origin. Such materials which have a linear curve in between V and I is known as an ohmic material. Now there are certain other materials which are known as non-ohmic materials. In case of non-ohmic materials, the curve in between voltage and current is not a linear curve passing through the origin. As you can see, in this case, we have considered a non-ohmic material, and the relation that we have obtained is a non-linear one. So this clearly does not follow Ohm's law, and such materials are known as non-ohmic materials. So the filament of a bulb is considered as a non-ohmic material. Why? Because the filament of a bulb is such a material which does not follow Ohm's law. Now let us find out how we can calculate the resistance of a given conductor if we have been given the graph in between voltage across it and the current flowing through it. So we are getting a graph, as you can see in this picture. This is an ohmic material. So if we have to find out the value of resistance from this graph, let us see how we can do so. First of all, we consider two points on the graph, P and Q. Now from these two points, we draw two perpendiculars each. From point P, we drop a perpendicular on x-axis at C, and we drop a perpendicular on y-axis at A. Similarly, from point Q, we drop a perpendicular on the x-axis at D, and we drop a perpendicular on the y-axis at B. Now notice the difference in between OA and OB, that is this length. This length AB will give us the voltage in that range, and notice the difference between OC and OD. This length will give us the current in this range, that is in the range P and Q. So if we simply divide this divide by this, that is delta V, the change in voltage going from Q to P, by delta I, that is the change in current in going from Q to P, we will get the value of resistance, that is delta V by delta I. We have studied that resistance is nothing but the slope of the graph, and here we are actually calculating nothing but the slope of the graph, which is Y divided by X. So we get the value of resistance from the graph of an ohmic material.